Hello, I'm Jill Slavny. I'm the executive principal here at Monroe to Orleans BOCES Career and Technical Education. So BOCES, it's a collaboration of a group of districts where they can pool their resources in order to be able to offer students more opportunities. So instead of every one of our districts trying to offer auto technology, auto body, culinary arts, machining, they pool their resources so that if they only have one student interested, they send them to our center. If they had 10, they could send them here. BOCES, really what we are, what we offer students today, which is lacking in a lot of their opportunities back at their home school, is that opportunity to explore careers. Regardless of if you already know you want to go to college, it doesn't mean skip over BOCES. This is an opportunity to come and some people say try on a career. We have students who get to go out and shadow, intern, co-op, or even just they replicate the day-to-day functions of a lot of the careers right here in the center. So even if they think they know what they want to do, some students come here and then after spending some time here they decide it's not what I thought it was, that's not what I want to pursue, or it will confirm what they're interested in. The industries have changed, the economy has evolved, and there are very few high-paying, low-skilled jobs. Those skills that are low complexity, where you're doing the same thing over and over again, those don't exist like they used to. So it requires a much stronger educational foundation and a stronger skill set in order to be successful, even in what people call entry-level jobs. You need to have a really strong math and science background. Everyone needs to be literate, obviously. And so that's what we offer our students. So they can choose to go right into career fields out of our center, or they'll pursue 2 or 4 year degrees. There are no limits, really. This is something that every student should consider.
Hi, Lily. My name is Courtney. I'll be your nurse today, and I'll be washing your hands.
There's a misperception that if you come to a career and tech center like a BOCES, that you don't have excellent math, science, English skills. They're critical in any of the trades that we train students in. You have to have those skills to be successful. It also gives them the opportunity to apply all those core academic skills in a real world application. Because a lot of times people think, oh, what do I need geometry for? Well, you need geometry. If you're building stairs and they're not on a 90 degree angle, people will fall down them. And kids don't realize that. So it just verifies for the students, yeah, geez, I really do need to know that. Our students have multiple opportunities. If they are doing well academically and have good attendance, they have the opportunity to do an internship or a co-op while they're here. So they will actually, rather than come to the building second semester, they go to an industry in their career field. And during breaks, they get to work a full work day. So they get to know what it's like to be on the job at 6 a.m. and to see, geez, is this really what I want? Our students also, because of the fact that they have the experience through us and the college credits, when they go to college, they're ahead of the game. I'll use welding as an example. Our students who go on to Alfred to major in welding, they have 2 years of welding experience with us. They're sitting next to somebody who's never picked up a rod in their lives. So they're way ahead. You know, they get to test out of some classes. They get to kind of be an exemplar student at the post-secondary level.
Still, the majority of our students are going on to post-secondary. Our strongest students, this is kind of like a flip. This is one of those misconceptions. Our strongest students go right into the industry because they came in with rock-solid academics, a work ethic, and the ability to kind of just absorb the skill set while they're here. So they'll get employed before they even graduate, and then their employer is sending them on for post-secondary. So they're not stopping their education. It's just that they're funding it through a different means. And so that's why I say those are our biggest success stories. Those students who co-op while they're seniors here, in other words, they're being paid to work in the industry during the school day while they're with us and they're senior in the second half of their senior year. And if they're offered a job, they'll go right into their industry, but their employer has already started a conversation with them about, we will send you to, and either they'll go to the local community college and they'll have it funded by their employer. So that's, with the cost of education right now, that's a huge win for our students. Some of our students, they're still not certain exactly where their niche is in the industry, so they'll go on to one of our local colleges. So they'll go on for post-secondary, but now they know that what they're pursuing is what they're interested in. So they're just going to get that education so that they can start at a higher wage in the industry, or maybe they just needed to kind of enhance their skill set. There is a local BOCES for every student in the state of New York. There are 37 BOCES across the state, and the best thing for students to do is to go to their school counselor. If they don't have a strong relationship there, any of the adults in their building could help them kind of navigate that process. But the counselors will help them decide. The career and technical education programs are offered to students when they're juniors. So once they get into high school, they have their freshman and sophomore year. to get that foundation, make sure they take all their core classes and that they're current. They need to be on grade level in order to offer the flexibility to attend a career tech ed center when they're a junior. I know in our center, we start working with our students when they're in eighth grade. We get them into our center, give them that opportunity to come explore and just visit at an open house, and then we bring them back as 10th graders so that they can set their schedule for junior year. There are no limits, really. This is something that every student should consider.